Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to solve a very specific type of differential equation called a linear equation. Here you can see it in yellow. It's dy dx plus p of xy equals f of x. And so when we're doing the problems, we're first going to write our differential equations in this form. Then we're going to solve them by multiplying by something called the integrating factor, which is I of x equal to e to the integral of p of x with respect to x. It is a very cryptic looking formula, and its derivation is really not that involved, but it does take some time. The important thing is that you memorize the formula for I of x. Let's go ahead and do an example right away. Solve the initial value problem. Our differential equation is x times dy dx plus 2y equal to 3x. And our initial condition is y of 1 equals 2. Whenever you have an initial condition and a differential equation, you have what's called an initial value problem. Basically, we're going to solve this differential equation, and at the end of the problem, we're going to use our condition, y of 1 equals 2, to find the value of c. Let's go ahead and carefully work through this solution. So it's really important to understand the basic form of a linear equation that we're aiming to get. So recall it was dy dx plus p of xy equals f of x. So that's the form we want, because after we write it in this form, we're going to find the integrating factor, which is I of x equal to e to the integral of big P of x dx. So in our particular problem, we have an x in front of the dy dx. Here there's no number or anything in front of it other than 1. So we're going to start by dividing everything by x. So divide by x, divide by x. The x's cancel. We get dy dx plus 2y over x. I'm going to write that as 2 over xy equals, and then the x's cancel, so we get 3. Now you can see that we can clearly identify big P of x. Big P of x is whatever's in front of the y. So in this particular case, big P of x is equal to 2 over x. So I'm just going to write that. Big P of x is equal to 2 over x, just so you have it. We're very, very aware of it. Now we're going to compute I of x. That's the integrating factor. So I of x is equal to e to the integral of big P of x, which we've successfully identified as 2 over x dx. This is equal to e, and you can pull out the 2, so this is the integral of 1 over x dx, which is equal to e to 2. This is a formula from calculus. Whenever you have the integral of 1 over x with respect to x, it's just the natural log of the absolute value of x plus a constant, but don't worry about the constant. And throughout this procedure, if you throw in the constant, it won't add anything of value to the procedure, so it's not necessary. We want to clean this up. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take this 2 and we're going to bring it upstairs like this. This is e to the natural log of the absolute value of x squared. If you're wondering how we did that, that was via a formula. If you have p times the natural log of x, that's equal to the natural log of x to the p. This is the power rule that you learn in algebra. So here we just brought up the 2. And then now the e and the ln cancel because they're inverse functions. So this is equal to the absolute value of x squared. And you can just drop the absolute value at this point and it's equal to x squared. In general, when you're doing these problems, you're always going to get an absolute value most of the time. So just get in the habit of dropping it. So I of x is equal to x squared. I should say something about that. A lot of times, for example, if you have instead the absolute value of x, you can just say it's equal to x. But then you have an assumption that x is, you know, greater than or equal to 0, or sometimes greater than 0. So it's always going to happen, and typically you'll drop it and not think about it. In some situations, you will have to come back, though, and think about it. Okay, so now we can go to the next step, which is to multiply our differential equation by our integrating factor. So I'm going to write it again, dy dx plus 2 over xy, and that's equal to 3. And now we're going to take this differential equation and multiply it by I of x. This is where it gets really interesting. So x squared dy dx, and then plus x squared times 2 over xy is equal to 3x squared. So just taking I of x, which is our integrating factor, and multiplying it by each term in our differential equation. We have some cancellation, so let's handle that. So x squared dy dx. We lose this x here because it cancels, so we have plus 2xy equals 3x squared. Okay, this is the most important part in this entire video, so I'm just going to write it over here. This is the part that everyone always gets stuck on, so this is the key step. Okay, the key step. So basically, when you get to this step, this whole thing here, which I've underlined in blue, x squared dy dx plus 2xy, is going to become, I'll write it over here, it's going to become d dx of your integrating factor, I of x, times y, where y is your function. So here it'll be d dx of your integrating factor, which was x squared, times our unknown function, which happens to be y. I say that because in some problems, it's another variable like r or, you know, z, so our unknown function, and that's equal to 3x squared. You're probably wondering why this is true. It's by the choice of the integrating factor. This procedure is a procedure that is contrived. Someone came up with it, and if you follow these steps, this will always work. So again, it's always going to be your I of x, which is x squared, times your unknown function, and you always have a derivative. You should always check, okay? Recall the product rule says if you have f times g, think of f as your first function and g as your second. It's the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. Apply that to x squared y. X squared is your first, y is your second. The derivative of x squared is 2x, that's the first, it's right here, times the second plus the first, which is right here, x squared, times the derivative of the second, which is dy dx. Again, the derivative of x squared, so the derivative of the first is 2x times the second, which is y, plus the first, which is x squared, times the derivative of the second, which is dy dx. You should always check. To get rid of the derivative, we need to integrate. So I'm just going to write integrate. I'm not going to put an integral sign because it makes the problem look way more complicated. When you write integrate, you just integrate the derivative so it goes away. So you get x squared y equals, here we use the power rule, so we get 3x cubed over 3 plus our constant of integration, capital C. We have some cleaning up here to do. We end up with x squared y equals x cubed plus c. In theory, you could leave your answer like this. I'm going to go ahead and solve for y by dividing by x squared. So when we do that, if we divide everything by x squared, we end up with y equals, looks like we just get x plus c over x squared, just like that. X plus c over x squared. And now that's the solution to the differential equation. Now we're trying to solve the initial value problem. Our initial condition was y of 1 equals 2. That means that x is 1 when y is 2. So we take these numbers and we plug them into this equation to solve for c now. So y is 2, and x is 1, and x is 1, so 1 squared is 1. We get 2 equals 1 plus c. Subtract 1 from both sides, so we get c equals 1. So our final answer is basically going to be y equals x plus, we said c was 1, so it's 1 over x squared, right? You just take the c and plug it back into y equals x plus c over x squared, and you get y equals x plus 1 over x squared as the solution to the initial value problem. Kind of a long problem, but once you do one of these on your own and you know the procedure, you should be in good shape. I hope this video has been helpful, and if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out other videos on Chegg. Good luck.